So we have with us, not next to us, but with us, unfortunately, Fernando Varela. Fernando, welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for an invitation.
This is a new type of interview. We cannot do anything different. You at your house, me at my house. How does it feel? The new era of communication.
It's strange. When we see about life, we think we never pass one thing like this, to have connection with a friend just by the telephone, just by computer, to see my kids know at the school, they have online school. It's a strange thing, but we must to adapt. We must to keep strong, and if the life is like this, you must to accept and keep forward.
In your life, I suppose that you have experienced a lot of difficulties, a lot of difficult situations, both as a football player and as a person. Which is the most difficult one?
I passed one very difficult situation with my biggest kid. Was more difficult than this for sure. I was young, I know everybody know I was father very young, and my kids stayed sick, and me and my wife we didn't have money to take the. To buy the things in pharmacy. This, I think, was the most difficult thing in my life, because my kid was with 39, 40 degrees sick, and we didn't have money to take the pills. And this, I think, was the most difficult thing of my life.
Let's speak a bit about this. How was your life before football and at the beginning of your football career?
I was a normal kid. I think I just when I was father, this change a little, change everything, because
How
with
old were you?
16 years old, to be a father is not easy. I must to finish the school. I finish the school. I speak with my family, because my kids need to eat, need to have a clothes, need to go to the kindergarten. And I decide to stop the school, to go to work, because the most important in the life is the family, the health of your family. And I take this decision, was hard decision for my family to understand, because they say they will support me whatever I want, whatever I need. But these things I don't like. I don't like people to buy things when I have two hands, two legs to go to work. And I say to my parents, no, it's not normal. I go to work, I buy these things for my son. And this was the most difficult period, when I was 16 until 2023, 24, was the most difficult period of my life.
How was it for you being a father in this age, when you are actually still a kid yourself?
Was difficult the first time. I didn't believe, because me and my wife we didn't was together in this time. We have a little bit problem, and we separate a little. It was a little. It was 9 months alone, because I didn't know before we break. We still. He have the kid in his belly, and we are separate. But I think this thing, you need the help of your friends, of your family, to pass this very good. Because I think my cousin was the perfect guy in this moment, because he helped me a lot. He say we must to go to see your son. We must to help in everything. And for this reason, I'm grateful of my cousin, because what he give for me, I will never return back whatever I give to him. And the life, what you can say, you must to change everything. You must to change the way of you think. You must to think. I was think like a kid, and you must to think like a man. from one moment to another, you must think like a man. Every action you take, you must take consideration. You have one kid, and you cannot make bullshit like with 15 years, 16 years old, you still do. And I must stop this. I stop a little with some friends because the life must go straight. Don't make mistakes because now you must take care about one kid. You stay all the way in your life.
Is it now that he is older, more a son or a smaller brother?
His son. It cannot be a brother. If he think like this, it's gonna be a problem for me, because you know the boys now they exaggerate too much with the father. We have a good relationship, but I must keep him. Keep him far, like father and son, because this is the most important. You must to say your boy, you are a father. You must to take care of them, and I think he understands very good. He's a fantastic boy. He don't have problems. We don't have problems. He understands everything, and we have a good relationship. But he's a father and the son.
Okay, back then when you stopped school in order to work. What was your first job? I know that you were working as in a pizza.
Yes. It was my first job. They say in Portugal the name is Telepizza. Or you go Telepizza or you go McDonald's in Portugal. This is the first job of the guys who have 16, 17 years old, 15. There the people start in Portugal, McDonald's or Telepizza. And I decided to start in the Telepizza. Me and my wife, we start together. He have 15, almost 16. I have 16, almost 17. We go together to the Telepizza. Was a fantastic moment now. I can say this. If I continue there, maybe not. I don't say this. But now I can say it was fantastic moment what we pass to start to work at 10 o'clock. To finish the 12 at night, to go buy feet at home, like 45 minutes by walking alone in the night, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock together, to laugh, to enjoy. And it was a fantastic period of my life because we still think like a kid. We go to work, we finish work, we go home together. Was good. This period was good to work, because there the money they pay always on the month was more difficult when I signed my first contract. But there in Telepizza was good period. So we enjoy. We have a good friends there, and it was the first job of my life.
How did you manage to cope with everything, with the job, with a kid, and to play football in such a high level?
You must have people around you who take care of you and of your kids. We have the family of my wife, also my family. They help a lot us. My father of my wife, one day he come to me and he asked me, "What you want? Like if you want to be a boy of Telepizza or a football player professional?" And I say, I want to be a football player professional. And from this moment, they take care of the son when I go, because I make the program to work in the morning, the Telepizza, afternoon night training, and the night I go home. In this period in the afternoon, they take care of my boy. My wife still work. They take care of my boy, and I go to training. That's why the thing was a little bit easy for me, because you always we have some people to take care of my son.
How long did you kept on working on the pizza and playing football?
I stay from 16 until my first contract till 19, 20. 20 years old, because I signed the contract professional 20 years old, and they say you cannot still work in the Telepizza. You must finish on this, because we training in the morning. And I finish from this moment.
if you had a backup plan, what would you do if you didn't manage to become a professional football player?
I think I will be something about this this sport, like fitness coach or physical coach. I want to be one of these things because in the school I like too much to stay in the in this part. I work a little bit more on these things. And I say always to my teacher, I want to be a physical coach, fitness coach, something like this. And I think if I will not be a football player, I will be like this.
Okay, let's talk now a bit about this whole situation that we all experience. Everybody is focusing on what's happening in Europe or the US or in China. And almost nobody speaks about Africa. You are from Cabo Verde. How's the situation there? Do you speak with people from your community?
Yes, the situation there is more difficult. Even if the less cases of corona, but it's more difficult because the hospital, the conditions to take care of the people is less than Europe. And imagine 3 or 4 cases there is like 1,000, 3,000 here in Europe. Because they don't have the conditions to work. They don't have the material to work. This is the most difficult for them. They have, I think, 3 or 4 cases there in Cabo Verde. And the situation is like the people, also they have a lot of old people. My country have a lot of old people. And if this pandemic take too much, there it going to be a difficult situation because the hospital is not prepared for this kind of virus. And always we speak, me and my teammates, national team, and we make something to help them. And I hope these things help a little bit the country. Because Africa, what happened in Europe and Africa is double or triple more. Even if it's less cases, because the condition of the hospital is very bad.
How do you participate in your community, you and the other football players, as you've mentioned? What can you do in order to help the people there?
What we do, we create some accounts. We put our the amount we can give to the people. And after the captain of national team, he speak with some people of government, and they make a deal to separate the money and to give the people who needs more. And these things what we do, and we try to help them how much we can.
Generally, do you feel the need of giving back something of the things, some of the things that you earned in football? Generally, not only, I'm not talking about money, I'm talking generally.
I can say yes, because what I have now is the I take back for every of my life. If I imagine when I have 15 years old, 16 years old, I will have this. I would say this is impossible. And like Saki say always to me, when you give something, you take the double back. And I think this is the most important in the life, to give. And for sure, in the one reason you're going to take back, it doesn't matter if it's money or another thing, but for sure you're going to take back. Oh, the love of my family, the love of my friends, something going to take back. And this for me is the most important. To help people, to try to help. And after, if I take back, you're going to be happy. If I don't take back, I will go to my life like always, I will be happy.
So you are from Cabo Verde, you grew up in Portugal, but now you're staying in Greece, and I think that you might stay for many years. How come?
Yes, because to take me away from Portugal is difficult, and my kids, they put this in my mind. My wife, here is the perfect country, perfect city. We have everything. We're gonna enjoy. My kids love too much to stay here. I love too much to stay here. But you know, the life is not like this. Football life is not like this. I tell them always to them, I want to stay always, I want to be with you. but you know football life, and they how much they feel happy, I will feel happy and it will be good for me. And this is the most important. And I think here in Thessaloniki, we have everything we need. Everything we need, we have here.
What makes you want to stay here, you and your family, in comparison with Portugal that you grew up and it's almost your country as well? What's the difference?
For them, for sure, friends. Because I think here they make a lot of friends. They also play in PAOK. They love too much the team what they play. They love the coach of they have. They don't want to go from here. And I think this is the big difference. They love to the club, to stay here, to enjoy. They want to be a football professional player of the first team. They both try to be. I tell them it's not easy like you think. You must work more hard than everybody. But when I be here in PAOK, they can work with me. And I don't say it's going to be more easy, but I'm going to help them to go like a professional player. And Thessaloniki, I think what changed the mind of everybody is the weather. The weather here is perfect.
What is more difficult, to watch your team play and you being on the stand, or watch your son play and you being on the stand?
Goodness. I think it's my son. When I see my son and I am in the stand, it's very difficult. Because when you are football professional player, you must believe in your teammates. And this is the good thing. I believe in them. I know when they go inside of the pitch, they give everything. But when it's my son, it's different, because it's part of your blood. And everything you want if him to do a good things in the pitch. And when you think like this, your heart go a little bit more more intensity. But I think it's when my son play, I feel more nervous.
Okay, when your son doesn't play football, they have school. And as I know, as you tell me, you help them with your school because they do it online. Have yes. you improved your Greek during this quarantine?
Oh, I think yes, not too much, but I think a little I improve. But because they don't have also too much Greek lesson, because Greek is Monday to Monday. They have Monday after next Monday. Because the most lessons they have is English, another ACL, another things. But I think I improve because I listen them to speak. They speak with each other. My biggest boy always, one time they say, now at home we speak just Greek. You don't speak Portuguese, you don't speak English. And I just try to learn from them some words.
Where do you believe we can discuss in Greek then?
I believe next year, I believe I will be not perfect, but for sure I can make one discussion.
So the next target is next season, your next interview, not your next, one of the interviews to be in Greek. Is that the deal?
Okay. I will improve to make one interview with Greek.
Okay, Nando, thank you very, very much for this. I won't call it an interview because it's in conversation. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Good to see you again. It was a long time I don't see you. It's very good to see you, because you are a good friend of PAOK, and it's very good.
Thank you very much, and I hope to see you soon next to me, not in a computer.
Me too.
Take care and train a lot.
Take care also. Take care and be healthy.
Thank you, Vare.